Welcome to the one more lecture on binomial distribution. This is a continuation of previous lecture. So here I am going to discuss few more examples on binomial distribution. Let me see one by one. First example, a probability that a person aged 60 years will live up to 70 years is 0.65. What is the probability that out of 10 persons aged 60 years, 7 of them will live up to 70 years? So here the first thing is we have to find what is P, what is Q, and what is the number of trials. So let me define P first. So let P be the probability that a person aged 60 years will live up to 70 years, and it is given by 0.65. So I can take P is equal to 0.65. So once we got to know what is P, we can easily find the value of Q also. So we have the formula like P plus Q is equal to 1. So Q will be equal to 1 minus P. So on replacing this P value there, I can estimate the value of Q. So it will be 0.35. I will get it. So and here the total number of persons are 10. So I can take the number of trials are n is equal to 10. From the binomial distribution, we have the expansion P of x is equal to ncx p power x q power n n minus x. The random variable x be the number of persons aged 60 years living up to 70 years. So that is, I got it, P is equal to 0.65 and Q is equal to 1 minus P, as already I told. So I will get Q is equal to 0.35. So and n is equal to 10 here. So once we replace all these values in the P of x equation, I'll get P of x is equal to 10cx 0.65 whole power x 0.35 whole power 10 minus x. So now the persons who is living 70 years, more than 7 people are given by this equation, that is P of 7 plus P of 8 plus P of 9 plus P of 10. So once we replace the discrete random variable values, x is equal to 7, x is equal to 8, x is equal to 9, and x is equal to 10 in the above P of x equation and summing it, the solution will be 0.5138. We will get it. One more example is, in a sampling, large number of parts manufactured by a machine, the mean number of defectives in a sample of 20 is 2. It is nothing but the mean of defective items are given out of 20 samples. It means that the value of n will be 20 here. So now we have to estimate for out of 1000 such samples, how many would be expected to have defective parts. So let me define P first. So let P be the probability of defective parts. Since here given mean is equal to 2 out of 20 samples, so I can take mean is equal to 2 and n is equal to 20. So from the binomial distribution, we have mean is equal to NP, so I can conclude NP is equal to 2. So I'll get NP is equal to 2, and since given n is equal to 20, if I replace both the values, NP is equal to 2 and n is equal to 20, I'll get P is equal to 0.1. So once I got to know about the value of P, I can easily find the value of Q also. From the equation P plus Q is equal to 1, I'll get Q is equal to 1 minus P, that is 1 minus 0.1. So Q will be 0.9. So once we got all this P, Q and N values, I'm going to replace this P of X values in the binomial distribution equation. So I'll get 20cx 0.1 whole power x 0.9 whole power 20 minus x. I will get it. I want to estimate to find at least 3 defectives in a sample of 20. The equation will be P of x is greater than or equal to 3. So since here it is a discrete random variable, I'm going to convert the equation like 1 minus P of x is less than 3. So I'll get the equation like 1 minus p of 0 plus p of 1 plus p of 2. So replacing x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2 in p of x equation and summing it and subtracting those solution with 1, the solution will be 0.323 we will get it. So now actually this is for only 20 samples. We have to estimate the same for 1000 such samples. So I'm going to multiply the obtained solution with 1000 samples. We'll get it 323 defective items. So one more examples on binomial distribution. So in 800 families, 5 children each. How many families would be expected to have 2 boys, 5 girls, either 2 or 3 boys, assuming the probability of boys and girls are equal. So since here each family having 5 children, I can take the number of trials will be n is equal to 5. And since they are given assuming the probability of boys and girls are equal, it is nothing but p will be 1 by 2, q will be 1 by 2. So it should be after adding both the values, the sum should be 1. So now I am going to replace this data in binomial distribution equation. So what will get it? If I replace the values p of x, ncx p power x q power n minus x leads to p of x is equal to 5cx 1 by 2 whole power x 1 by 2 whole power 5 minus x. So since here 1 by 2 whole power x 1 by 2 whole power minus x is there, I can cancel it. I got it p of x is equal to 1 by 2 whole power 5 5cx. The same thing. Actually, this equation is applicable only for single family. I want to estimate the same for 800 families. So I'm going to multiply the probability with 800 families to get the frequency distribution f of x is equal to 25 5cx. So now I'm going to estimate exactly 3 boys. I mean, out of 800 families, how many families will be having exactly 3 boys? We will check it. So I'm going to replace x is equal to 3 in the obtained frequency distribution equation. So I will get 25 into 5c3, I will get 250. So it means that exactly 250 families will have exact 3 boys. Next is, I am going to estimate out of 800 families, how many families will have 5 girls children. So in the frequency distribution, I am going to replace x is equal to 5. So I will get 25 C5 is equal to, I will get 25. It means that 25 families will be having exact only 5 girls children. I'm going to estimate either two or 3 boys. So it is nothing but f of 2 plus f of 3. So seeing in the probability, since R term is there, we can use plus sign here. So since 25 is common, I can take 25 common factor. 25 into 5c2 plus 5c3, I will get it here. So on simplification, I will get 500. So it implies that 500 families will be having either 2 or 3 boys. So in the next lecture, I am going to discuss about Poisson distribution. Thank you.